And here, my dear friends, is one more video for you. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share with a friend. I am gonna talk about how to choose the implant for your body. Now, there are plenty of academic sites everywhere. Most people can't understand the words they use, the scientific words. So you guys know, I am known for bringing very complicated scientific terms and concepts to the most simple possible verbiage, okay? So we're gonna talk about how to choose the size. Very, very simple, my dear friends. Just grab a ruler. Of course, medicine is in metrics, okay? So measure from armpit, axilla, to armpit, axilla, okay? So I'm about 34 because I'm a man, but most of my patients are going to be approximately 26 centimeters to 30 centimeters. And so basically each part of the body has an index of beauty, okay? The breast, that index is how separate the implants are. Certainly you've seen on the beach people walking around with one implant here, one implant here, and you know, you can put two fists between her breasts. We don't want to be dependent forever on bras to give us cleavage, because as I said, some of the beaches of the world are topless, and I don't want you to walk around, or even an intimate moment, I don't want you to walk around with two very separate breasts. So let's already put them in the right place. So let's look at the table of sizes, okay? What is the correct perfect distance between implants? About a centimeter and a half, the thickness of my finger, okay? That's the separation your implant should be. So everyone says, I wanna go small, small, small. 80%, 31 years I've been a surgeon, 80% or more of all patients have regretted the size they chose, my dear friends. Don't make that mistake, because you're gonna pay for it twice. First of all, let's talk about sizing. You said, oh my gosh, I want 300, I don't want 400. Well, we are underneath the muscle. It's kind of like sitting on a beach ball. The muscle squishes the implant. In my experience, you lose about 100 cc's. Repeating that, remember that in America, many countries not the case, but in America, you're underneath the muscle. Makes sense, because we don't want to occlude a tumor on mammogram. We don't want to be inside the breast and hide a tumor. Again, oversimplifying everything, but you're going to be underneath the muscle and the muscle is going to squish it. So as I said, in my experience, you lose about 100 cc's, okay? So you say 400, you end up with a looks that looks like 300. Be careful, be careful. Don't throw your money away, okay? 400. It's about... It a 415 in that range, it's gonna be almost 12, okay, rounding up, almost 12. So that makes sense. Look, from here to here, you're 26. So 12 diameter plus 12 diameter leaves a space of what? About two fingers. Perfect. Not surprisingly, one of the most common implants in my experience, about 400. If you pick too big, it's going to stress tissue, especially tissues damaged by the sun and by pregnancy, and it's gonna be some damage. But it seems to be about 400, okay? So 300, you see, it leaves a huge gap. 300 is approximately 10 centimeters, okay? And 350, about 10 and a half, approximate, okay? So let's use very simple, if the concept of implants is something very difficult for you, let's use simple home implements. If you pick two ping pong balls, of course they have to be centered underneath your nipple. You can't have the nipple here and put the implant here. So obviously we have to center under the nipple. So if you pick two ping pong balls, how much space are you gonna have? This entire space here, very ugly. Let's say you pick two tangerines. Is that sufficient? That's not sufficient. How about if you pick two lemons? This is about the size of 250. Look at the huge space between the implants. Now, I'm oversimplifying a little bit. How about two apples? Okay, getting better, but still a big distance between implants. What is it that we really need? Two half grapefruits, okay? Two half grapefruits, okay, guys? So, make the right decision so you don't have to go back and pay twice. Surgery has its risks, so you don't have to pay twice for your implants. This is Dr. Ray discussing how to choose sizes of implants for your body. And remember, Dr. Ray is the king of beauty and the king of health. And I love you. Ciao, ciao.